Good morning, students. Welcome back to Digital Electronic class. In today's class, we are going to discuss the same concept, that is nothing but the Karnaugh map, but with some slight change in it. That is the nothing but we are going to continue the K map by using don't care condition. Basically, what is a don't care condition is all about? You know that in digital electronics, the digits can be 0 or it can be 1. But apart from 0 and 1, when you had a digit, when I'm having a digit, I can say that the digit can be 0 or I can say that the digit can be 1. 1, when I'm saying that the digit is either 0 or 1, I'm not sure about that. That means I'm not sure that whether the digit is 0 or 1, then it is called don't care, which is represented by letter X. So this X indicates my digit can be 0 or it can be 1, but I need to use that in place of 0 or 1, we can write X. That X is called it as, it's called it as don't care condition. So in this, what you are actually, we are going to see, in this we are going to see, how do we take for the Karnaugh map or a K map to design in digital electronic, how do efficiently you can use it, this X, for designing the logical gates or logical parts, whatever the things we'll going to perform. In order to do these things, we are going to use this bit called don't care bit. So by using the don't care, what actually we are going to see? We are going to see the function, complexity of the function can be easily get it. So in order to get that, those things, we are going to perform that particular part by using the don't care. So in this, we are going to simplify some functions, we'll take some function, and we will able to find out the answer for it. So suppose I'm taking one question in which they gave certain bits as a don't care and certain bits as like a mean term. So we need to design the K map for giving these two conditions. So how do we do it, that particular thing? We can do it. We had the question, simplify the Boolean function. The first question is, simplify the Boolean function. F is equals to summation M of 1, 3, 7, 11, 15. 1, 3, 7, 11 and 15 plus D. So what is that D indicates? It's nothing but don't care bits. So D of 0 to 5. So they give D of summation 0 to 5. So they gave the mean terms and even they mentioned the don't care bits in that. So we need to perform the K map. We need to simplify this function by using the K map. So in that, they gave the condition using Karnaugh map or K map. So they gave this question. So what is the question in this? They gave the function 1, 3, 7, 11, 15 and they gave 0 to 5. So they gave these two bits and they asked to perform by using the K map. So in this, how do we understand this is don't care given or not? By you looking into D. They can mention D or they can mention 5. That means those bits are nothing but like a don't care bit. So as to perform this thing, what we need to do, as you can see, bits are ranging from 0 to 15. That means we required 4 variable K map. So we are designing 4 variable K map. So each square box represents one mean term. So we are making 4 square box. Some of the students still getting the doubts with what bit they need to combine. I'm getting lot of queries about that. So please look into it in a proper way. So they gave these two bits. First bit is AB, next bit is CD. So we do have AB and CD. In this, what is the first combination? 00, 01, 11 and 10. Like this 00, 01, 11 and 10. So what is the first box represent? Its mean term M0. Next box M1. Like this M3 and M2. So 01, 23. Likewise M4, M5, M6 and M7. Then M8, M9, M10 and M11. M12, M13, M15 and M14. So what are the values given? 1, 3, 5, 7, 11, 15. So 1, 3, 5, 7, 11 and 15. They gave like this. So we have taken 1, 3, 7, 11, 15. So 1 is 1, 3 is 1, 5, 7, 11, and 15. After that, they gave the bits of don't care. That is 0 to 5. So what is 0? Here I can make a cross mark. That is don't care bit that indicates by cross X. Like this 2 and 5. So 2 is also there, and 5 is also there. So we are just, it's 15 we do have, right? So 15 we already took. So 1, 3, 7. So 1, 3, 7, 11 and 15. So 11 and 15. This 5 is don't care. So what is given? 0 to 5. So at 0, at 2, at 5. So we have put all that particular bits. Whatever they gave in the question, we have done with it. Next thing, how do we combine? First thing, while you're combining, you keep in your mind, first preference is given for 8 combination. Do we have 8 adjacent ones? Is it present or not? If it is there, then you combine it. If it is not there, try to combine 4 ones. If you do have 4 ones with that, if it is not there, then try to combine 2 ones. So first thing, we'll look into 8 ones. Do we have 8 ones anywhere we can do it? No. Here is 4 ones is there, I can get it. Here also I'll get the 4 ones. So I can combine. What I can combine it? I'll take it like this. This don't care condition also we need to consider. So what I'm doing? I'm combining these 4 ones. So this is what? X also we combine, this X also we combine. In 1 and 1. We got one combination. Next thing, this I can combine. I got this next one. So what I'm getting? I'm getting this one and this one. I'm not taking this. Why I'm not taking? Because it is don't care. If it is required in the combination of the mean term, then only take it. Otherwise, leave it. So here we required because adjacent cell, right? Here we can take it and we got one chord. If I combine this one like this, already this one is covered. No need of taking further. Only once we have taken, that's enough. This is left out, that will leave it. If it is useful for our one, then only it will be taken into consideration. Otherwise, it will be kept as it is. So how many chords we are getting? We are getting 2, 3, 1, 0. That is one chord. Next is 3, 7, 15 and 11. We got another chord. So we got the bits 1, 3, 7, 11, 15. 1, 3, 7, 11 and 15. We're done with this. Next is 0 to 5. So we do have 0, we do have 2, we do have 5. So we have combining this particular part so that this is make it as chord. Because this is useful for our ones. Whereas this is not required. This is what don't care, don't consider into that particular bit. So that's the reason we are skipping. So that point you need to keep in your mind while you're combining the bits. So now tell me what is the first thing we got? We got M0. M1, M2, M3. That is our first quad combination. Similarly, I can take next one. M3, M7. M3, M7, M11 and M15. We got another quad combination. So tell me, what is the answer for this? For these rows, only AB is common. And remaining all are changing. So that means this only the answer for that. What is that answer? Ek bar and B bar. For the next one, M3, M7, M11 and 15. 3, 7, 11, 15. What is common in this? CD is common. So I can write C and D. Right? So we got these functions. As per the question, we got the first function as well as second function. What is the total answer of this one? What is F is equals to? F is equals to A complement, B complement plus C and D. That's it. And what is the conclusion of this problem? It conclude that whenever we had a bit 8-bit combination, do we are getting any kind of 8-bit? If it is possible, then you can take it. For example, if you do have cross here, then I can combine this 8. Adjacent cell is there, no? I can combine easily. But I don't have this. That's the reason I'm combining this one. Likewise, here is there. It is useful for these ones. Because this is adjacent to this one, this is adjacent to this one. So I can combine that also. I can make it as one more chord. That's how I got one more chord in that particular mean term. So that's the reason I have got the first chord and the second chord. Both of them, the total answer of that particular Boolean function is F is equals to A complement, B complement plus C and D. So this is the way you can do the functions when they gave Boolean functions of that series. So likewise, you can go for another function. If they give another way of designing, we can do it. So take another questions. They gave one more problem. We'll solve that one. So first, You need to keep this in mind. Then we will try to solve one more problem by taking this same method. By taking the don't care, how do we efficiently take the don't care condition? By taking that, we can get it. Take the next problem, students. So in the next problem, what they gave? They gave the function f is equals to what? We had f is equals to, this is the question. This is the second problem. A Boolean function f is equals to w, x, y, z. They said this variable we have to consider. Specifically, they mentioned till now, whatever problem we have done, they have not mentioned any variable. So as per the question, we do have this variable w, x, y, z with summation of 1, 3, 10 plus summation of don't care. 0 to 8, 12. So they gave 3 mean terms and they gave 4 don't care bit. So as per this one, we have to design the K-map and we have to write the simplification function, simplified function for this condition. So as you can see, the variable itself, it is what? It's a 4 variable K-map. In this, what we are taking? We are taking 4 variable K-map. These problems are very important. It definitely will ask two kind of questions. They'll give you for K-map and they'll ask A bit, B bit, 10 marks question for sure. So keep on practicing. As you practice more problem, you'll get habituated of it and you'll get the answer for it. So I'm taking this one. I'm taking this particular Boolean function with the 4 variable. I'm taking the K-map. So 1, 2 and 3. So like this, 1, 2, 3. The first, what is the first variable they said you? Wx, here is yz. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0. So one more logic what you can remember. If you forgot in exam, if you have taken 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, then your answer is gone. Remember that between each adjacent cell, bit is differ by only one digit. That means only one bit can be differ between these two types of it digits. That means if you see 0001, only single bit is difference is there. Likewise, if you see in these two adjacent cell 01 and 11, that means this 11 is same. These two bits are just a single bit is different. Likewise, 11 and 10 in this also, the single bit is differ. That you need to keep in your mind. If at all, if I have taken 0110 here 11, that means these two bits are different, these two bits are different. That is not the logic of K-map. K-map states that between adjacent square box, only bit is differ by a single digit. That's how we have taken it. Now take each box as M0, M1, M3 and M2. So M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. Then we'll start from the end. M8, M9, M10. M11, next M12, M13, M14 and M15. So what is this given in the question? 0 to 8, 12 is don't care. So 0 is cross, then 2. So 2 is cross, 8. Where do we have 8? 8 is cross and 12. So we do have 12 is here, it's cross. Next given mean term is what? 1, 3 and 10. So 1 is 1. 3 is 1, 10. So we have a 10 here? Here is 10. Clear? So we can get like this. So I can combine this 4 part, this one whole thing, I can combine and make it one particular chord. So I can combine like this also, corner edges. 1, this is another 1, this is another 1, and this is another 1. I can get one more. Why I'm combining? Because I want to get this 1. First preference is what? 8. 8 combination. Do we get 8? Not possible to get anywhere because there is no adjacent ones. Can I make it as 4? Yes, I can make it. This corner, if I fold it, I'll get 4 ones. It will come at one end. 4 ones in the sense, 3 are crosses, 1 is there. I can do it. That is a possible way of doing it. So what I get now? Tell me the first combination I do have is M0, M1, M3 and M2. In this, what is a common in all? W bar and X bar is common. W bar and X bar. Now look at it in the corner part. So M0, M2, M0, M2, M8 and M10. So in this, what is common I can write? I need to look into row wise in these two boxes and column wise that two boxes. In row wise, if I'll see, Tell me what is the common? X is 0 here, x is 0. So I can write it as x complement. If I'll see vertical way, what is common in these two? 0, 0 here, here 1, 0. That means z is common. That z is 0. That is z complement. So I can write this two. Why I'm leaving this one? This is also there, right? Why I'm leaving? Because it's a don't care. If at all that bit is required to combine with ones, consider it. Otherwise, leave it. So we are leaving this. We don't require that bit. If you had one here, if you do have cross here, then I can combine it. I'm leaving this one specifically because it's a don't care. It's not required. So what is the function now? F is equals to? We got W complement, X complement plus X complement, Z complement. So I got this function. If at all they ask to realize it, by using the logic gate or gate level design, we can do it. So they just now, they only asked to write the function. So we wrote it as per the given condition. So in exam, try to remember, if at all you do have the combination of adjacent cells 1, 1 is there, then only we'll consider this don't care. Otherwise, we leave it. This don't care I'm considering because I can make this 1, 2, 3, 4. Four coordinate cells are there. I can fold that particular thing, I'll make it as one chord. That's the reason I'm getting that answer. So this is the way you can do the K-maps. So in that K-maps, what we have discussed? We have discussed about SOP form, how do we take NPOS, product of sum, mean term, max term, even the don't care condition problems we have done. So I'll give some questions, you try those questions and try to get the answer and solve in this way. And show me that, and if you at all you had any query, you can even mail me that particular query. I'll give the update of that particular query at that particular time. So I'll give the questions, you try to solve that particular question. Before doing it, make a notes of this particular question. So take the question, students. So our first question is, implement the Boolean function f is equals to. So they gave the question to implement Boolean function f is equals to a, b, comma c with summation 0, 3, 5 plus summation of 5, that is don't care, of 1, 6 and 7. So they gave this question. So by using K-maps, they gave the question to implement the function by using K-maps. That is the first one. Likewise, we do have the second one. Obtain Boolean function f is equals to 0, 5, 6, 9, 12, 15 plus don't care of d is equals to 11, 13. That's it. They gave these two values as don't care. I mean, they gave the function. So by using again K-maps, that is the second one. Likewise, you can take next one. So obtain f is equals to this is f is equals to, they gave you 1, 3, 6, 7, 8, 0, 2, 4, 5, 11, 15. Don't care it is, and by using the K-map. So this is the question they'll give you. You need to solve it for don't care conditions. Our next topic for discussion is when we had the universal gate. What are the universal gates are there? NAND and NOR. That NAND and NOR equivalent functions we need to write for our basic gates in terms of universal gates we are writing. That means first gate, what type of gate we have to talk about? OR. Second gate is what actually? AND. So how do we write OR in terms of NAND? So basically what is NAND gate is there? You do have NAND is nothing but AND plus NOT. So first is A, B. So you do have A, B whole complement. This you need to write, you need to get this function. So what is OR equivalent? Normally OR means you have two gates, two inputs value A and B, and if you are adding this one, it will get A plus B. Right? So we do have like this. So you want to write that in terms of NAND. So similarly, what is AND? One gate is there, A and B, and A into B. So AND means you are multiplying. So if I want to take like this, if I'm taking like this one gate, AB, if I'm giving, so what is the answer for this? AB bar. Once again, if I'm connecting with one more, AND, that means I can write AB bar and whole bar. What is A double complement? It's nothing but AB. That means this gate is similar to two NAND gate in series. I can conclude. That means if I'm taking one AND gate, I'll get till here it is AB complement. One more if I'm connecting, that means complement is there. One more complement I'm doing. That means it's equals to AB. So if they gave in the question, if they gave two functions A and to B, if you had, you want to write that function in terms of NAND, this is the way you need to do it. Similarly, if I want to get OR in terms of NAND, how do I do it? I'll take first input like this. This is what A. I had till it is A complement. Single input I'm giving. Likewise, I do have second one B. If I want to write the complement of it, I'll get one more complement like this. So if I want to take two gates into series, so if I'm having this one, till here it is what? A complement into B complement whole complement. Like this I got. So by using De Morgan's law, what is De Morgan's law states that? A into B whole complement is A complement plus B complement. This one I'm applying over here. So see what I did? I take one A, single A. I'm connecting with one NAND gate. So I got output of NAND gate is A complement. I'm getting one more input B, I'm connecting with one more NAND gate, I got B complement. Again these two connected to one more input. So what I'll get for this? Again I can make one complement. So what I'll get? So if I want to segregate this one in by using that formula, I can write A double complement plus B double complement. That is nothing but A plus B. A plus B is a function of OR gate. That means OR gate, if you want to design by using NAND gate, you can go in this way. So one OR gate is equivalent to three NAND gate in parallel, and one AND gate is equivalent to two NAND gate in series. So by using these NAND gates specifically, they'll mention in the question, they'll give some condition, try to implement by using, they'll mention NAND gate only. That means you cannot use NOT, you cannot use OR and AND. These gates you cannot use it, these are basics. They mention specifically by using NAND gate. So we'll have to implement by using NAND gate that particular function. So let's see how do we do it. So first, before doing this thing, you need to keep in your mind all these functions. How do we convert it into one particular function? So that if you understood, then remaining gate simplification will be easy. So once again you see, if you had AB, I'm passing with one AND gate, I got one complement. One more time I'm passing means I got one more complement. The two complement will be gone, only we got AB. So this AB and AB are same. That means it's nothing but like, what it is? It is nothing but like your AND. So this is similar to AND gate. So AND gate is done. Likewise, I can go for OR. What is OR means? Addition, A plus B you have to get. For that what I'm doing? I'm connecting one input with one NAND gate, another input with one more NAND gate. These two I'm multiplying and passing to one more NAND gate. So I got whole complement. So that whole complement, by using De Morgan's law, I can do it like this. So let's see some sort of problems based on this. So we had one question. So question is what? They gave a question. Implement the Boolean function f is equals to AB plus CD by using NAND gate. So by using NAND gates, we have to implement this AB and CD. So first of all, you tell me A into B is nothing but like an AND gate, right? For AND gate, what we'll do? We'll take A, we'll take B. We'll pass to one NAND gate, and again we will pass to one more NAND gate. So first, what is the name I'm giving? This is your A, this is your B, right? Till here, what is the answer for it? AB complement. After passing to one more NAND gate, AB complement, whole complement is nothing but AB, right? We got AB. Next one I can write CD. What is C? This is your C, this is your D. Passing to one NAND gate, another 1 we are passing to one more NAND gate. This is CD. So here it is CD complement. After passing to one more NAND gate, CD complement, double complement is CD. Right? So we got CD here, we got AB here. We want to get what actually in between that? Addition. Addition means OR gate. For OR gate, what we'll do? We'll pass these two inputs to one more NAND gate. So what is the answer for this? AB plus CD complement we got. AB into CD, not plus, it is what actually, it's an AND gate, right? So AB into CD, one complement. But do we want to get complement and dot? No. What do you want then? We want addition. So for that, what I'm doing? I'm passing to one more NAND gate. So what I'll get? AB dot CD, one complement and whole complement. I got like this. So this is not my function. But still what I can do, I can apply De Morgan's law. A plus B or A into B, whole complement is A complement plus B complement. That I can write. So what is that? AB double complement plus CD double complement. That's this way I can write. So this is nothing but AB, this is nothing but CD. So that is nothing but our function F. So you see what I did? I did, they gave this function, so I gave to AB till here. I got AB answer by connecting two NAND gate. Why I'm connecting like this? Because NAND gate function is what? If you do have two functions A and B, if you want to pass to it, I can write AB complement. That way I can do it. That is nothing but the output for NAND gate. Similarly, for the second one, I'm taking C and D. I'm passing to one NAND gate, I got CD bar. One more time if I'm doing, I got double bar. That is nothing but CD. So AB and CD I found. Next thing what I asked, I want to get addition. So I'm not getting the addition. If I'm passing to one more NAND gate, I'm getting the complement and dot, because NAND gate will give into and dot, into and then complement. So that in order to remove that one, I have connected one more NAND gate. So I got double complement like this. This is nothing but De Morgan's law. This whole is your A function, this whole is your B function. So A dot B whole complement is, if you do have A dot B whole complement, I can write A complement plus B complement. That means AB complement whole complement, because we do have two here, plus CD complement whole complement. So I got AB plus CD. So this is a function. They asked only NAND gate. So see, everywhere in the whole designing part, you are getting only NAND gate. Everywhere only NAND gate is used to design that function. Basically, if you want to use basic gates, what we'll do? We'll take A into B, we'll connect one AND gate, C into D, we connect one more AND gate, we'll add, that is by using OR gate. That is the basic gates. So in the question, they did not ask basic gate. What is they specifically mentioned? They mentioned by using NAND gates. So by using NAND gates, we can design in this way. So see student, they give next question. F is equals to ABC plus CD plus DE by using NAND gate. So here what we'll do it, we had the function. In this, there are three terms in that. What is the first thing what we'll do? We'll take one NAND gate. We'll connect how many inputs? ABC. Right? So we're connecting with what? NAND gate. So what is the answer for this NAND gate? ABC bar we got. So we don't want bar. Do we have complement here? No. So we will pass with one more NAND gate. So what is the answer of this? ABC bar with one more bar is nothing but ABC. So we're done with first part, ABC we found. This part is done. Next thing, what is required here? C and D. Already we had C, so we'll take like this. We'll connect one C and I'll take with one more input D. So this two, I'll pass with one more NAND gate. So what is the answer of this one? I got CD. This is your input D, this is your C. The CD complement here, CD complement with double complement, that is nothing but CD. We found CD. Next, we want to get DE. How do we get DE? So D already we had, so we'll take that D connection here and we'll take one more input. We'll mention this is E. So this is nothing but we'll pass with one more NAND gate. So we got this is DE. So this is what here it is, DE complement. Here is what? DE complement with double complement, because we connected with one more NAND gate, that is DE. All are added. So as you can see, here is also added, here is also added. What I'll do, I'll take these all connections I'll pass to 1, what? NAND gate, because in the question only NAND gate is used. So what is the answer of this one? ABC into CD into DE, whole complement I do have. This thing I had. Next thing, what I need to do it? I need to remove this complement part. In our question, we don't have the complement. So first thing, we need to remove that complement. So in order to remove this thing, what is the required step we need to do? We have to make one more complement, and we have to make by using De Morgan's law. For doing this thing, what we'll do it? We'll take one more NAND gate. So I'll get total answer is ABC complement, ABC, then CD, then DE, whole complement with whole complement. I got like this. This I can write as ABC double complement plus CD double complement plus DE double complement. That is nothing but ABC plus CD plus DE. That is your complete function F. So your function F, you can realize by doing this method. That means by using NAND gates, you have taken ABC, CD and DE. By taking these all, we have taken the horizontal approach. This is what kind of designing? This is horizontal. Vertical also we have seen, right? So by using horizontal approach of gate level designing, in that these are called what type of gate it is? It is universal gates. By using the universal gates, by taking all the inputs, we have designed our function. So this is the way, if they gave the question, you can design the NAND gate. So you can just make the notes of these gates also, designing of the gates, and try to practice by taking your own questions. It will be helpful for getting habituated of these kind of questions in order to get the capture of this one. It will be very easy if you understood. If it's very dry, if you won't understand. So try to practice, you'll get this answer. So thank you for today's class, and try to practice the question. We will see the more concepts of NOR gate. How do we convert? Since we have taken all type of gate is NAND, right? How do we take a NOR gate? That we will see in the next class. Thank you. Have a good day.